وينصب اليمنى ويجعل أصابع وينصب اليمنى ويجعلها عن جانبه الأيمن ويجعل أصابع اليمنى متجها به للقبلة وباقي أصابع اليمنى على الأرض.
And then a person props up his right foot and places it towards the right of his body, making sure that the bottom part of the toes are facing the Qibla like this.
نعم. هذه جلسات الصلاة. أم إلا في التشهد الأخير في الصلاة الثلاثية أو الرباعية يتورك. نعم.
And this is the sitting in the prayer, except in the third rak'ah and in the third unit and the fourth unit of a prayer, then a person, sorry, this is the sitting of the prayer.
في كل جلسات الصلاة.
This is the single sitting of the prayer in all of the prayers. However, when the prayer has three units or four units, then a person does a tawarruk.
والتورك وصورة التورك أن ينصب اليمنى واجعلها من عن جانبه الأيمن واجعل اليسرى أسفل من تحت الساق اليمنى. نعم.
And this is that a person props up his right foot like this and places it towards the side and then places his left foot at the bottom and sits on the backside.
يستحب له أن يقول بين السجدتين رب اغفر يجب عليها أن يقول بين السجدتين رب اغفر لي مرة واحدة.
And it is an obligation for a person to say رب اغفر لي at least once as an obligation between the two prostrations, between the two sujood.
واستحب له أن يزيد بما ورد.
And also it's recommended for a person to increase in this, in that which has been narrated from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
رب اغفر لي رب اغفر لي رب اغفر لي.
A person can say this.
أما أن يزيد بغير الوارد عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يقول رب اغفر لي ولوالدي أو يقول سمع الله لمن حمده ربنا ولك الحمد والشكر قبل والشكر هنا ولوالدي في بين السجدتين هذا من البدع. نعم.
Ask for a person to say something in the prayer or something between the two prostrations which the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم didn't say, then this isn't permitted. Rather, this is an innovation. For example, instead of a person saying رب اغفر لي, oh Allah forgive me, a person says, oh Allah forgive me and my parents. To say and my parents between the two sujood, this isn't something which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to do, and therefore it's an innovation, a
bid'ah.
If a person wants to pray and supplicate for his parents, then he can do this either in the prostration, in the sujood, or after the tashahud.
أو قبل التسليم.
And before the tasleem.
نعم. ثم بعد هذا يكبر بلا رفع يدين ويسجد كما سجد في الأولى.
And then once again, a person says the takbir without raising the hands and goes into the prostration once again as he did before.
ثم يقوم إلى الركعة الثانية مكبرا بدون رفع اليدين. قائلا الله أكبر. نعم.
And then a person stands up from the second sujood saying Allahu Akbar without raising the hands.
ويصنع في الثانية ما صنع في الأولى.
And then does the same thing in the second prayer just as he did in the second unit, just as he did in the first unit.
إلا أن الركعة الثانية ليست كالأولى في تكبيرة الإحرام. تكبيرة الإحرام في الأولى وفي الثانية في هنا تكبيرة انتقال من السجدة الثانية إلى الركعة الثانية. نعم.
And the only difference between the first rak'ah, the first unit of prayer, and the second rak'ah, the second unit of prayer, is that there is no takbiratul ihram. So in the first unit of prayer, there is a takbiratul ihram. As for the second unit of prayer, it is saying Allahu Akbar to symbolize a movement.
نعم. وكذلك الركعه الثانيه ليس فيها دعاء استفتاح.
And also in the second unit, in the second rak'ah, there is no dua al-istiftah. Subhanak Allahumma bihamdik, we don't say this.
فَإِذَا تَمَّ الرَّكْعَةَ الثَّانِيَةَ وَبَعْدَ أَنْ سَجِدَ السَّجْدَةَ الثَّانِيَةَ يَجْلِسْ لِلتَّشَهُّدَ الْأَوَّلِ.
So once a person has completed the second rak'ah in the prayer and has...
إِذَا تَمَّ الرَّكْعَةَ الثَّانِيَةَ بَعْدَ السَّجْدَةَ الثَّانِيَةَ يَجْلِسْ لِلتَّشَهُّدَ.
So once a person has completed the second unit of prayer, the second rak'ah, and has completed the second sujood, then he sits.
يقرأ التشهد.
And in this sitting, the person recites the tashahud, التحيات لله and all of it.
ويستحب له أن يصلي الصلاة الإبراهيمية على النبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم إذا كانت الصلاة ثلاثية ورباعية عن هذا التشهد تشهد أول. نعم.
And if the prayer has three units or four units, then it's recommended for a person in the first tashahud after it to say to send salutations upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by saying Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad and so on.
وَإِنْ كَانَتَ الصَّلَاةُ نَعْيَةً كَصَلَاةِ الْفَجْرِ.
And if the prayer is a prayer of only two units like the Fajr prayer,
تكون الصلاة الإبراهيمية ركن من أركان الصلاة.
And then sending salutations and blessings upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a pillar rukn.
ثم يستعيذ بالله من أربع.
And then after this, a person seeks refuge in Allah from four things.
بأن يقول.
By saying.
اللهم إنا نعوذ بك من عذاب جهنم وعذاب القبر وفتنة المحيا والممات ومن شر فتنة المسيح الدجال. ثم يستحب له أن يدعو بما ورد عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وهو أولى أو بما أحب. نعم.
And then after saying this and seeking refuge in these 4 months as the Shaykh just recited, then it is recommended for a person to make other supplications.
ثم يسلم عن يمينه السلام عليكم ورحمة الله ثم عن شماله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
It is recommended for a person to say the supplication which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say, or say any supplication that a person wants. After this, a person makes one taslim to the right and then another taslim to the left.
لا بد أن يكون التسليم برأسه لا بمنكبيه لأن هناك من ينحرف عن القبلة بمنكبيه. نعم.
So when a person says taslim, says assalamu alaikum rahmatullah, he doesn't say it by moving the whole shoulders and the body, rather only by moving the face.
ويتحقق من أن الوجه يكون عن الجهة اليمنى. نعم. ثم عن اليسار.
And it's not for a person to move his face, all the face, all the way to the right, and then all the way towards the left direction.
بعض الناس هدانا الله إياه يطقطق الرأس ويرفع بين التسليمتين أو قبل التسليمتين.
Sometimes some people they move the head up and down before the two taslims or in between the two taslims.
أو يحرك يديه أو يضرب بهما.
Or a person moves his hand like this. When making the taslim.
فإذا سلم.
And then after making the taslim.
يأتي بالأدعية الواردة عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. هذا إذا كانت الصلاة صلاة فريضة.
Then after a person making the taslim, if the prayer is one of the obligatory prayers, then the person mentions the supplications and the remembrances that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to mention.
ولم يثبت عن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام أنه دعا بعد صلاة. أي صلاة لم يدع بعدها النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And it has not been narrated or established that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم used to supplicate, used to make dua after the prayer. Any prayer, it's never been established that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم ever supplicated after the prayer.
بل هذا من الجهل أن يترك وقت إجابة الدعاء وهو ساجد أو قبل التسليم ثم يدعو في وقت ليس بوقت دعاء بل هو وقت استغفار. نعم.
And this is from ignorance. That a person leaves the place where he should be supplicating and where the supplications are answered, i.e. in the prostration, in the prayer, or before the taslim, and instead of this starts supplicating after the prayer.
لدى الصلوات المفروضة ما يسمى بالسنن الرواتب يعني سنن مرتبة مع الفروض مؤقتة مع هذه الفروض الخمس. نعم.
And then apart from the obligatory prayers, we have other prayers which are called Sunan al-Rawatib, i.e. those highly recommended voluntary prayers which have been attached to a particular prayer.
Rak'atan qabla al-Fajr.
So for example, the two units of prayer before a person prays the Fajr prayer.
Wa arba' rak'at aw rak'atayn qabla al-Dhuhr.
And then 4 units of prayer or 2 units of prayer before Dhuhr.
وركعتين بعدها بعد الظهر.
And 2 units or 2 rak'at of prayer after dhuhr.
والعصر ليس له سنة راتبة لكن إن صلى قبل العصر 4 rak'at فهذا وارد عن النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام.
And as for the asr prayer, then it doesn't have any rawatib sunan. But if a person prays 4 units of prayer before asr, then this has been mentioned by the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
وركعتان بعد المغرب وركعتان بعد العشاء.
And also 2 units of prayer after Maghrib and 2 units of prayer after Isha.
أهم هذه السنة الرواتب ركعتا الفجر.
The most important of these highly recommended units of prayer are the 2 units of prayer before Fajr.
لم يتركها النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم لا في حضر ولا في سفر.
The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم He never left off praying these two units of prayer before the Fajr prayer, whether he was resident or whether he was traveling.
لها فضل أكثر من فضل بقية الرواتب السنة الرواتب.
And it has a virtue more than the other units of prayer. The other sunan al-rawatib.
خير من الدنيا وما فيها. لو قالوا لك نعطيك كل ما على الكرة الأرضية ركعتا الفجر خير من هذا كله.
And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that the two rak'at before Fajr are better than the world and everything in the world. So if somebody came to you and said that I will give you the earth and I will give you everything which is on the earth, then the two rak'at before Fajr is better than this.
يخفف هذه الركعتين دون إخلال بالأركان.
And a person when he prays these two rak'at before Fajr, then he prays them relatively lightly and quickly, but without being deficient in any of the pillars.
يقرأ في الأولى بعد الفاتحة قل يا أيها الكافرون في الثانية بعد الفاتحة قل هو الله أحد.
And a person should recite in them after the Fatiha in the first rak'ah قل يا أيها الكافرون, and in the second unit of prayer after the Fatiha قل هو الله أحد.
أنواع السجود.
What are the different types of sujood, the different types of prostration?
سجود السهو وسجود التلاوة وسجود الشكر. أخذنا فيما تقدم سجود الصلاة. الآن نريد نبين سجود السهو وسجود التلاوة وسجود الشكر. نعم.
So we have already studied previously the sujood, the prostration in the prayer. We also have other types of sujood. We have a prostration that a person makes due to forgetfulness. We have a prostration that a person makes due to reciting the Quran, and we have a prostration that a person makes in gratitude or showing shukr to Allah.
أهم ما يكون عند سجود السهو السجود الذي سببه السهو للعمد, لأنه لو تعمد ترك ركن فالصلاة باطلة, تعمد ترك واجب فالصلاة باطلة كذلك. نعم.
The most important prostration that we have outside the prayer, after the prayer, is sujood al-sahu, i.e. that prostration which is done out of forgetfulness in the prayer. So if somebody leaves something on purpose, somebody leaves a pillar on purpose, then the prayer is invalid.